Yeah, it kept getting slower and slower because shot making wasn't really easy. And those have been the nature of wickets we've seen so far because, again, we're playing on the same track just 2 days ago. We played on the same track. So the wicket kept getting slower and slower, but we batted, didn't really bat to our potential because it was a gettable score. I just felt that the batsman let the team down. When Hardik got out, it was still run a ball. When Jaddu got out, it was still run a ball. So in these situations, I think shot selection was really, really crucial. And at times, I just felt that they erred in that. See, you need to assess the conditions. It's not that at times you need to play the situations well. And when you're batting higher up the order, which MS is doing, and with the kind of depth that we have in the batting order at number 6, 7 and 8, I mean, when the 6, 7, 8 don't really come off, so he can't play with the kind of freedom that he should. So it all boils down to how the batsmen at the other end are also batting and how many wickets we have in hand. And because one of our plans is definitely not to lose too many wickets in close intervals. And that's something we try to do, that when the wicket falls, we try to rebuild. He's already done really well in the test format. You saw in the last season that how he actually crossed one line, because his match-winning performances in the Dharamsala test, in the Mohali test, when the team was really down, he produced some brilliant innings for the team. But as far as one-day cricket goes, he really bats lower down the order at number 8. And I feel that, you know, those are certain things that he'd get magnified, because ultimately, you cannot relate only the lower order contribution to the end outcome. It's also what we did, especially early on in the innings, that's also look on. So let's not be too harsh on Jadeja.